Hi, this is Clay Nickel, Chief Investment Officer and Strategist with Arvest Wealth Management, and I want to welcome you to our October Viewpoint video. It was about 3 weeks ago that we released our September video, and since that time, we've seen a decline in stock market prices, in bond prices, in commodity prices, and in just about every global currency save the US dollar. If you recall, in September, we were advocates that long-term investors remain committed to their asset allocation plan and their investment strategy. And we still hold that view, which I'll speak to in just a moment. If you also recall, in August, we mentioned that those that are in retirement or those that are taking draws from an investment portfolio to supplement income, that it would make sense to raise some cash given the July and early August market advances that we had seen. That type of strategy still would hold for retirees and those that need income from their investment portfolio and take regular draws there. We would advocate that folks in that position do so on market strength to begin to build a cash store that they can use for regular living expenses. And in August, we recommended 6 to 12 months. Obviously, every investor has a slightly unique situation. And so we still say that you should talk to your financial advisor in regards to what the best plan is for those types of cash raises. For those that are long-term investors, however, these types of market fluctuations are things that can be weathered. And if we're talking about long horizon, we're talking those who have a 10-year investment window or longer, which quite honestly is just about every investor. Even those that are nearing or in retirement are going to have a decade or a multi-decade investment horizon. So why would we say remain committed to the markets? The simple fact is that we are in a heightened volatility time, but that volatility can work both ways in the markets. Our equity team will continue to remind us during our strategy meetings that corporate profits remain resilient and are forecasted to continue to advance into 2023. Now, just a quick word here. We see a bifurcation between what we would call bottom-up analysts, those that are looking at company financials and cash flow projections, compared to top-down strategists and analysts who are looking at the broader macro picture. The macro analysts or strategists tend to be much more pessimistic than those that are actually digging into the company's financials. And so we've got a bifurcation here. That said, there are a balance of risks to both the upside and the downside. While the macro news, the macroeconomic news continues to look dire, and there are lots of different ways you could find a negative skein to what's going on in the economic and market environment, when we dig into the company financials from an earnings perspective looking forward, there is a reason to have at least a, I'll call it a glimmer of hope. In those types of situations, it is possible for the market to advance and to continue to advance. Now, while we still anticipate that there will be a recession in 2023, this does allow some time for the markets to continue to work. For those that need to raise cash from an investment portfolio, you'll have windows of opportunity to do that. But for the long-term investor, those that might react to what is going on in the news environment and what they see every day, whether it's mainstream news media or whether it is financial media, there are a number of folks that are getting nervous, and we understand that. What we have seen, though, is that those that sell after an already sizable decline, U.S. stock markets are down about 20-25% as of the date of this recording. If they sell after those drawdowns, maybe escaping some additional pain of, let's say, another 10 or 15% drawdown, it is very rare for those same investors to also put money back to work near market bottoms. And the reason is because the news is still awful when the market bottoms. So if you're waiting for good news to either reinvest, what we have seen historically, at least in my 2 decades plus of experience, is that those investors rarely time that correctly. But when we look at long-term market horizons and we see these types of events, whether it was 2020, whether it was 2008, the early 2000s, the early 90s, these types of market environments, even in recession, for those that have a longer investment horizon, tend to be blips on the screen. Now, all of this said, one of the things that has changed, and our economic team and fixed income team has pointed this out, there are some initial signs of financial stress as a result of the Federal Reserve's tightening. And so with that, we do see that there are some risks, but we were anticipating that some of these would occur. It is not a 2008 type financial crisis. It would probably be more akin to 1998, the Asian financial crisis. And if you don't recall that exactly, that's my point. It ended up being a significant event in financial markets, but for the average investor, those that, again, were investing for the long term, it really did not make a difference in their financial goals and whether or not they could achieve those. So we continue to stress that if you are a long horizon investor, you continue to keep in mind that these short-term fluctuations, while unnerving, will not derail your financial goals. Just a quick word, we will have our webcast and we encourage you to join that. That is interactive. You can ask questions of our portfolio management and analyst team. And of course, we always refer you back to the written viewpoint, which has additional detail on some of these topics that I've just mentioned. Until next time, thank you.